Hi guys, my name is Byfair from RFN. Welcome to Inside Destiny for the week of the 14th of November. Coming up on the show, we've got big news as the PS4 launch event is incoming with exclusive Destiny content. A hunting knife has been displayed in the Destiny drawing board. Another build has been finished in the studio. Art and Ghosts is up on the community focus. All this and more. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to go ahead and say it. Against probably what is good decision making on the behalf of getting a console that doesn't cost more money, I'm getting an Xbox One. That doesn't mean I'm not pumped for PS4 though. It looks like it has some wonderful games, and also a wonderful launch event being hosted with Spike TV in New York at 11 p.m. local time there, and 4 a.m. in the morning for me. Well, that's nothing new. In the meantime though, we have someone coming out called Jeff Keighley, who is saying that there will be exclusive Destiny content at the big launch event being hosted by Spike TV in New York. And this is something cool, because we've seen that Destiny and Activision have partnered specifically with the PS4 guys over at Sony, and they're making exclusive content for that system. I would likely suspect this is the point at which we're going to find out what that exclusive content is. Either that, or it could be something else big. We have talk about speculation of a release date. We have talk about speculation of more gameplay footage being shown. We have speculation about a new class. We had tweets going out about the Hunter and how it supposedly can kill things without even firing a shot. A massive crowd of things, supposedly. This is intriguing given the fact these tweets didn't just come from some employee of Activision. They came directly from the Bungie feed. The Bungie feed. So, what do you guys think this is going to be? That's your question this week. I want to know, what do you reckon we're going to see coming out of this PS4 launch conference? Because it's huge. This event is massive. I think you can be bound to see some of the larger figureheads from Bungie there. I wouldn't suspect someone like Harold Ryan, but most certainly community guys like Erk and Deej will be there in New York. So, tell me guys, what do you think it's going to be? I personally am going to say it's going to be exclusive content for the PS4 and a release date. I'm going to go ahead and say it may be a trailer as well. If it is a trailer, then you can guarantee I'm going to be over the moon, because I love me my trailers. And now for something completely different. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Destiny drawing board this week. Something that rivals the cusp of every technology that we've seen so far, with something a little bit more refined, a little bit more basic, but at the same time, just as deadly. Ladies and gentlemen, this week we're taking a look at the Hunter Knife. The Hunter Knife, which is being shown just here, is a concept for the melee weapon of, I would presume, a hunter. The reason I say this is because previously, in clips specifically from the Destiny Community Thank You video, we have seen hunters wielding this weapon as well as the Traveler's power. This is also confirmation of what was seen earlier in a tweet, stating that the hunter would have a way of killing enemies without even firing a single shot. This is most likely that way. We'll take a look at this further. The handle itself is not just designed to be held in the palm, it's designed to be held around just the fingers. This allows for a much more stealthy approach, and plus it means that you can sneak around with this kind of thing. Also notice on the blade the symbol of the hive. Perhaps this isn't the symbol of a hive, it looks similar. For sure, I'm going to flash that up on screen as well in just a second, but it is also a huge possibility. If this is somehow faction related, it explains why we might find it openly in the world. The design on the blade looks absolutely beautiful. I'm kind of thrown away on it, really. It's fantastic. A weapon like this, I mean, it's a combat knife, obviously. For most small enemies, I'd expect it would be one hit kill. But it does explain some intriguing ideas behind the assassin-type nature of hunters, and it means they're much more than just the rogue standing there in the frontier. They are very much a force to be reckoned with, in the same way that a titan or a warlock would be. So this is exciting, guys, and plus it could mean more melee weapons. So we had the Bungie Weekly update this week, and sadly, well, not so sadly if you look at it from our perspective, the Bungie guys have moved on to another build of Destiny, as was spoken about. They had hunters and titans and warlocks that they made in that previous build, and now it's been shredded and is being moved on. Honestly, this stuff is happening. I think it was only 2 weeks since they removed their last build as well, so you can tell the pace at which they're going through these. This shows the real pace of the development up till launch. So, what did we learn from this? Well, we learned quite a few things. We got some neat little screenshots, which are coming up in a second, which really were the main focus of a lot of the community. Because people just looked at this and then they gave us a few glimpses at locations. You know, you had things such as the background in the next screenshot coming up, which is just gorgeous, with some old space shuttles. Some people speculate this is an old Russia, but it's a different design of spaceship, so I'm not too sure. This one, of course, of the Hunter, which is just fading now. We're not sure where that is. We think that's on Venus, but we're not sure. And then, of course, later on you have a Warlock who is just waving goodbye. All of these, I love the little kind of filters they've put on these. Obviously, this this is something they do in post-production, but it's just nice to see the stuff they put on this. In the meantime, they were taking builds of Destiny home to play on the couch to see how it runs, so that shows you progress up to the beta. And also, we take a look at it, apparently Venus is getting new environmental factors, so I'm assuming the artists at Bungie are busy at work. Not much else really discussed in this weekly update other than a lot of mail sack questions, which I'm not going to go over because none of them are that conclusive, other than the fact that Bungie employees will be in the beta. So, look out for them. Claim their heads. And now we come to the community focus, and this week we have three things of note, because this week has been quiet for Destiny, I'll be completely honest, although I'm assuming next week is going to be insane given the PS4 launch. So, first of all, we had Cannibal423 with his Destiny fan art. He's going to be starting a series on RFN talking about how to draw your own Destiny fan art. This is something he mocked up really quickly, so that gives you an idea of the kind of talent we're talking about. This is things such as art, getting the proportions right, getting lengths of faces and limbs, etc. So really just how to draw it. Then we have this awesome Hunter being drawn by Leviathan from DBO. He's the kind of resident artist with those guys, and I love his work. He's also done some previous shots of Titans and Warlocks and Hunters, and all of this really great kind of pencil shaded art style, and I personally love it. I think it's fantastic. Plus, the mythos he likes to add behind all these, such as the crate being carried, it makes you ask questions, which is what's so ingenious. Plus, that Hunter, man. That Hunter. I'm gonna cut it off there and leave you guys with the illusion being shattered that I'm a complete gentleman. In the meantime, we have Ghosts and Echoes, the series that I host along with Craig Hargrove, and it's really kind of, I'm not going to even explain too much about it other than the fact it's about a story of an AI called Strauss. Please go and listen to all 9 episodes so far. It's really getting interesting. You'll want it because it's also a bi-weekly Destiny news thing. And you should get into the story. It's this awesome expanded lore thing. Go ahead and watch it. In the meantime though, I think that pretty much wraps up our show. Remember to subscribe to RFN, remember to like this video, remember to leave those comments on your favourite weapon as well as what you think will be at the PS4 launch. Remember to favourite if you really like this video, follow me on Twitter at InsideDestiny, like us on Facebook, and remember Guardians, it's not about the heart that you put into things, it's about how much British steel goes in. Okay, I'm just kidding, I'll cut it off there. Para Dacia Astra, I'll see you guys starside.